Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today, I'm going to explain about somatic hybridization. Procedure for successful somatic hybridization: isolation of protoplast from suitable plant, mixing of protoplast in centrifuge tube containing fugigenic chemical, that is chemical promoting protoplast fusion, such as polyethylene glycol, which is about 20% weight by volume. Then next is sodium nitrate, and then maintenance of high pH at 10.5 and temperature of 37 degree centigrade. As a result of fusion of protoplast, viable heterokaryon are produced, wall regeneration of heterokaryotic cells, then later fusion of nuclei of heterokaryon to produce hybrid cell, then plating and production of colonies of hybrid cells, selection of hybrids, subculture, induction of organogenesis in the hybrid colonies, transfer of mature plant from the regenerated callus. These are the procedure for successful somatic hybridization. Fusion of protoplast of potato and tomato and production of hybrid plant called pomato will be done. For this procedure, first we will take a protoplast of Solanum tuberosum, that is a potato plant, and then Lycopersicum esculentum, that is tomato plant. So protoplast from these two plants will be taken, and fugigenic chemicals are used so that protoplast fusion will take place to form heterokaryon, and then the plating of fused protoplast will be done. Growth of hybrid colonies will be seen later, selection of hybrid colonies, plating on medium, hybrid callus formation takes place, then transfer of callus to nutrient medium so that hybrid plant will be produced, that is pomato or tomato. Application of somatic hybridization and hybridization. Somatic cell fusion appear to be only means through which two different parental genome can be recombined among plants that cannot reproduce sexually. Protoplast of sexually sterile, like for example haploid, triploid, aneuploid plant, can be fused to produce fertile diploid and polyploid. Somatic cell fusion overcomes sexual incompatibility barriers. In some cases, somatic hybrids between two incompatible plants have also found application in industry and agriculture. Somatic cell fusion is useful in the study of cytoplasmic gene and their activity, and this information can be applied in plant breeding experiment. Many disease resistant genes, that is example tobacco mosaic virus, potato virus X, club root disease, could be successfully transferred from one species to another. Genes responsible for tolerance to cold, frost, salt could be successfully introduced through somatic hybridization. Example, introduction of cold tolerance gene in tomato. Somatic hybrids with high nicotine content and low erucic acid have been developed. Hybridization has made it possible to transfer cytoplasmic male sterility. Limitations: it does not always produce plants that give fertile and visible seeds. Regenerated plant obtained from somatic hybridization are often variable due to somoclonal variation, chromosomal elimination, etc. Protoplast culture is associated with genetic instability. The production of variable somatic hybrid is not possible in all instances. There is no certainty as regards the expression of any specific character. There are limitations in the selection method of hybrids, as many of of them are not efficient. Somatic hybridization between two diploid result in formation of amphidiploids, which is not favorable. That's why the haploid protoplasts are recommended. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.